we found a little bit of information on an exchange that you had with Gary Vaynerchuk, and we kind of happen to be, you know, we like Gary. We find him to be intriguing. And he, you know, one of the things that you had said was that you recognized that he was changing the world of wine, you know, in his venue, which is video, social media, all of that. So any thoughts on just kind of where the wine market, wine business is going and how social media is playing a role in that?
Well, I think social media, to the extent that it's being used as you folks use it or as Gary uses it, it's going to play a huge role, obviously. It's going to play a huge role regardless, but it could go either way depending on, you know, who's holding the camera and the microphone. But what I instantly liked about Gary, and I've seen in your own blog that you do, folks do the same thing, was that Gary would... First of all, he's got an oversized personality, and that helps. I mean, that's obviously, he's not boring to watch under any circumstances. But when he tastes, he tastes well, he critiques well, he obviously has a great palate. But he quickly qualifies his observation to say, look, you may like this. I don't, because I mean, he admits that he likes vegetative wines. Mm-hmm. Well, I don't think too many people do like vegetative wines, but he admits that he does. But quickly qualifies to say, hey, this is my taste, or he doesn't like, he's quick to judge a wine as being over-alcoholic. I think too quick. But that's fine, because he talks about the way everybody should think about wine, which is, this is my palate.
Right.
You know, don't not buy this wine if you like this style, or if you find that you like these styles. This is just my palate. And I think that's the essence of where wine has to go to really become...
Right.
For this really to become a wine-consuming nation, we are a long way from being a wine-consuming nation. I mean, the average person still does not have a bottle of wine with dinner, or, you know, open a bottle of wine for dinner in this country. It's more of a rare experience for the average person.
That's a sad state of affairs.
Well, now I look at it as actually the opposite, which is that, you know, we do in this industry, if everybody who's making good wines is doing pretty well, and we've done pretty well over the last 20 years. And when you consider that our per capita consumption is still around 2-3 gallons per capita versus some of the countries like France and Italy in their heydays were up to 30 gallons per capita. They're all well down from that now, but we'd have to be at least 7 or 8 or 10 gallons per capita to be a true wine-consuming nation. So the good news is that opportunity is there ahead of us. So there's just wonderful room for growth and expansion. If we wanted to drink that much wine right now, I don't know where we'd find it. I mean, we'd be drinking a lot of very bad wine, because that's what we'd have to do, is go get the wines that are being dumped in Europe and other places, simply because they're not of a quality that people want to pay for.